Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatic channel. Today, I'm going to take a look at a new design with production done by Riot. This is the Krypton One, a Tashi Barucha design that stood out the second I laid eyes on it. Coming in two different sizes, the number one is the larger of the pair. With a handle length of 5 inches, this particular variant comes with the zirconium inserts in the show side and is very attractive in my opinion. Coming in with a thickness of 51/100ths of an inch, the accordion style lock bar tension relief and 3D mill clip complement the body lines well. Designed to resemble an integral, the Krypton takes on more of a blocky look and feel in hand. If you take a look at the show side, you will notice the lack of any exposed hardware. And if you look towards the start of the frame, there are two milled windows that when closed, only one window displays text. The second window displays kickstop, referring to the flipper mechanism designed by Lee Williams. The Krypton has two means of deployment, the fuller and the kickstop flipper, that after it flips, the blade breaks away from the tab and stops at the spine side of the handle, leaving no break between the blade and the handle, which is definitely more appealing to the eye. But the tab will no longer cause finger placement issues. In the open position, the windows read the blade steel and kickstop. Coming in with a blade length of 3 625/1000ths of an inch and 150/1000ths of an inch blade thickness, the number one is definitely a monster and a lot more knife than expected. Comprised of 154, that's a flat ground tanto sporting a full length fuller. And just as Sashi told me on Instagram when I asked him, the fuller is definitely functional. The tanto blade has a hand rubbed satin finish, and other than the text displayed in the window, the TB design logo is the only marking on the blade's show side, while the other side is sporting the Lee Williams kickstop logo. The action is on par with other high-end Riots. The kickstop is very responsive, and as I've somewhat read, has an assisted type of snappiness to its deploy. The fuller is very accessible in the closed position and feels assisted in the same way as the tab. And what I mean by this is, it feels like the detent overrides finger pressure and sends the blade out. The retraction, on the other hand, isn't affected by the tab mechanism. And at first, you might think the tab may slow down the retraction or add some type of double clutch closing. And the answer is no. With just one minor shape, the blade will fully retract. Coming in with an overall length of 8.5 inches and a weight of 5.4 ounces, the Krypton is a handful. The sides of the frame come together forming an integrated backspacer as well as a lanyard hole. And this is where the build is missing something in design, and that's just my opinion. Although it's not bad by any means, I feel the spine side of the handle is lackluster, mostly the lanyard hole. Although innovative, it just doesn't fit the design for me. Riot's fit always speaks for itself, and the same goes for their grinds and hand rub finishes. But to me, the build starts to fall short from the blade steel choice, and again, it's not horrible, but it's used on every Kershaw launch ever. And this is the first I've seen it on Riot. And I've also heard some people say the build doesn't bear enough Tashi design language, and I do remember the arrival of the T-Series, which is still hot today. Some say it's missing the raised handle, which I think Tashi wanted to create something different and break away from its previous mold. The larger model is the only Krypton with windows milled out, and I have handled the Krypton 2, which I am also fond of. And with that, let me know you all's thoughts on the Krypton with kickstop. Is the hidden tab overrated, or does it look a lot cleaner? Share, like, comment, and subscribe. Signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.